listen to the roar that greets the announcement of Waldner's name. That's the esteem in which he's held in table tennis.
At this stage, the player's entitled to 2 minutes knock on the table. Just simply going through a few simple routines. Backhand and forehand drive, just keep the ball on the table. Get a feel for the conditions.
Whole wealth of experience between the two players. Out of the Swedish contingent, a big contingent here to watch this. Sen, only 21 years old at the early part of his career, against Waldner at 31, who's achieved everything and still wants this title badly.
Jan Sen, as we can see, a penhold grip player, uses the smooth type rubber, the black side there. Jan Sen, excellent footwork. He'll be looking to play his forehand topspin whenever he can, but of course, Waldner will be doing everything he can to prevent him doing so. Last minute advice from Ulf Karlsson, himself a former world champion, 1985 world doubles champion. And he'll be giving last minute words of wisdom to Waldner. The umpire now calling the player to the table. To serve.
So here we go then, the first men's singles semi-final. Fantastic start. What a shot. Is he sharp or what?
He's certainly buzzing in the first 2 points. That's a very, very difficult shot. What he's actually doing, he's not using the black side, he's maintaining the penhold grip, but he's actually using the opposite side of the bat. Very difficult skill.
Well, this is unbelievable. This is what Gatien was suffering at Waldner's hand in the quarter-final, but he's straight in taking the initiative, is Jan. Dramatic beginning, all 5 points off his serve.
The penhold grip for the service, the high throw up, fast accelerating wrist, can almost see the spin on the ball there on the slow motion. Now one of the finest servers in the world. Two outright points on service there.
Well, this is just fantastic.
Jan making his tactics very clear.
Has seen everything in his career. He's seen opponents start like this. He won't be phased.
Forcing Jan to play backhand from the backhand side, then the winner into the forehand. But again, Jan there. He's looking to get his forehand in at all costs. He's coming round the backhand side. He's got excellent footwork And this really is going to be an interesting tactical battle. Good tactics there by Vollner, even though he lost the point. He was going out wide to the forehand, and then I'm sure he would have gone into the backhand.
Well, he's whipping that forehand across and giving Vollner absolutely no chance to launch the backhand reply.
Slight kick on the table there, Vollner misjudging the return.
Oh, it's deja vu, but it's exciting stuff. 8-point lead.
Four, 11, Sweden.
Changes the point of attack and misses it. It was a more simple shot.
He's the first one he's missed so far this game. An absolutely magnificent start by Jansen.
5-11.
Very good return of serve by Jansen. What's been very impressive is his touch over the table, quite clear that he's got superb footwork and a fast forehand topspin, but he's also got very good touch around the table.
6-12.
Vollner there, surprising him with a long fast serve. Sets up the rally, the fast serve. And then Vollner's in with that forehand topspin.
7-12.
Well, Vollner just fetching it back to a certain extent, the momentum, but still the sharpness that Jan began with is with him. 6-point cushion, and now his sequence of serves.
That backhand, when he plays it with the other side of the back, if you can get that, that'd be
excellent. Well, wherever he goes with the forehand, it seems he's striking gold.
Both these players using side spin to great effect as well. It's not now just a case of top spin, they're actually putting the spin on to angle it away from their opponent.
15-8.
And remember, in Jansen, you're watching the guy who's ranked 8th in his own country, ranked 47 in the world, and yet playing like a god right now. Nothing 15, he can do with that.
Jan not sure which way the ball was going to kick, and here we see it, quick wiggle of the wrist underneath the table, difficult to see, and excellent slow motion there. You could see the ball kick to the right.
Vollner's beginning to come at him. He stopped the hemorrhaging of points. Wonderful action shot there. Just 3 points adrift now.
Clever variation there from Vollner. Spun the ball up a little bit higher, a little bit more spin on it, forcing Jan to block off the end of the table. The margin now down to 2 points.
Missed it. You can't believe it. It's the first cross-court forehand that he's missed, I think, all game.
Totally misread the service there. Vollner shielding it with the free arm, topspin on the ball. The push from Jan flew off the end of the table. Here we see the service. comes out underneath the arm, the top spin, and misses by a long margin.
So from 7 points down, Waldner is now on level terms, 15 each.
15-16.
And now he's in front.
Very difficult to predict what Waldner's going to do. On that occasion, the long push to the forehand. Good tactics.
Jan just looks a little bit lost as Waldner begins to impose himself on this match. And there he took the cross court and won the point.
Played out wide to Jan's forehand, invited the topspin, punched it back into Jan's backhand, forced him to play backhands from the backhand side.
Waldner, three successive points against serve. Oh, yes. He's still there, Jan. Still capable of untold brilliance.
Again, the same tactics into the backhand, but this time Jan quick enough to get round and make that forehand topspin from the backhand side.
Sweden.
Well, he stopped the rot, 2 points in a row, but Waldner's looking pretty at the moment. 18-17 with his serves to come.
Waldner, of course, took all 5 points with his last series of five serves.
To the roar as Waldner eases closer to the first game, 19-17. Extraordinary shot.
Almost a hook here, he comes round, it's side spin on it from that position, taking it wide to Jansen's backhand.
3 game points for the Swede. Just a phenomenal game from Jan Elde Waldner, and in it you saw everything that makes him the climactic figure he is in world table tennis. He was under the cosh there, he was 7 points down, he was up against a guy playing unbelievable tennis, table tennis, and he countered it. And he must be feeling very, very good indeed. And he won the game going away, 21 points to 17. Welcome back, and the atmosphere evident, I'm sure, for you at home. It's an atmosphere that's been building for the best part of an hour. 3,000 people packed round this number one court here to watch Jan Ove Waldner of Sweden, 31 years old, the world number two, up against an opponent who played just staggering tennis at the early part of that game, but Waldner held his nerve as we knew he would, but could he have the form to counter it? Well, he did so in spectacular fashion. Best of five, game two.
Second game, serve Sweden. Lovla.
Put out. Great serve there from Vollner. Good use of the wrist, the fast serve down the line. The flat backhand there. Only just missed. Very clever service there. Cut underneath the ball, heavy backspin. Janssen in the net.
1-4.
Again, heavy backspin. Janssen simply can't read the spin. Completely misread it there. The ball almost hit the table before it reached the net. Excellent service.
Well done. Important thing for Jan is not to lose his nerve here. He must be feeling a little vulnerable. He's played phenomenally well, and yet he's staring at a game deficit.
I don't think he's ever played so well and lost in that first game. And of course, that can be very disturbing.
Just moving off balance. Again, Waldner outmaneuvering him. 3 points in front. And he seems to be reading him now. Forehand down the line, looked a pretty good shot. Waldner was there with time.
The hallmark of a great player, isn't it, that? He had so much time. Saw it before anybody in the hall.
Oh. Just extraordinary.
Invites the top spin. Thank you very much. The block down the backhand. Wonderful play.
With side spin as well.
4-8-2, Sweden.
He's got to keep himself together, otherwise he could be blown apart here. This is a big test right now of Janssen.
Even though he missed the service, Janssen, again, he's causing confusion. The long, fast serve to the forehand. Just overhits it there. It bounced a fraction too high on his side of the table.
8-4.
And that really is the problem when you're up against the master, Waldner. You're never sure what shot he's going to play or where he's going to play it to. Down top spin there, excellent use of the wrist, brush the back of the ball.
10-4.
Top spin on the service there, pushed by Janssen. Virtually impossible to keep it tight when you push the long top spin serve. There he's pushing it, and Waldner in with the top spin.
10-4. Close to the table and far away. He was about 4 metres back when he played that winner.
Interesting backhand here from Janssen, if we look carefully. He's playing his forehand topspin away from the table. Just didn't quite see that backhand.
5-11.
Well, Waldner thought he'd got it, played for that, forcing him wide. Just couldn't control the topspin.
7-11.
Now, Jan looking in better shape.
7-12.
Excellent return from Waldner there. Pushed it back short to Janssen's forehand, the service, he read it well. He touches it short there, and Janssen's topspin catches the top of the net.
4. Oh, gorgeous shot. And that shot said a lot about Jan. It shows he's not lost his nerve or his guts to play the difficult shot.
Great drop shot there from Janssen.
13-8.
Heavy backspin on the serve. Jansen completely misread the spin. Again, heavy backspin. It looks so simple, but it's so difficult to do to return these serves. Can't see the point of contact between bat and ball.
15-8.
Well, he got the first one, misread the second, and once again, Waldner racing away from him. 15-8.
16-8.
Again, an outright winner with the serve.
17.
It's too good. And Jan is just completely struggling now. Just can't pick Waldner's serve. And all round, Waldner just seems to have too much for him. 8-17.
8-18. Look at that background. He turned his background.
So a 10-point lead.
9-18.
Yeah, no problem.
Yep. 9-18. 10-18.
Well, he lost the point there, but he's playing phenomenal table tennis as he had all day. Remember earlier on today,
he beat
Jean-Philippe Gatien of France, the former world champion, beat him in straight games.
18-12, Sweden.
Struggled on the serve there, though.
A bit of his own medicine there. Completely misread that himself. Excellent serve from Jansen, but now, of course, Jansen has a big problem. Waldner's got five serves.
19-12. Blistering shot. Waldner can hurt you in so many ways. And here's another. Bops up the serve as Jan and then crash.
20-12.
And he hasn't fallen off his pinnacle since the middle of the first game. 8 game points.
20-13.
Hardly a crisis yet.
15-20.
But now,
China.
Moments of difficulty because serve changes. Game points saved.
Yep. Let serve there, actually. Jansen, very sporting, gave the let serve.
Waldner noticing that someone hadn't changed the score back. Still game point. And the game. Extraordinarily high performance from Jan Ove Waldner. Playing as well as he has at any stage in his career. And this, remember, the Olympic champion in 92, the world champion in 89. Could he win the world championship 8 years after he won it in Dortmund? Still keeping cool, which is above all his trademark. 2 games to Lovie Leeds. He'll be back for the third. So the hand clapping begins as we await game number 3. Jansen has had a tremendous tournament, ranked 47 in the world, unseeded. He's blasted his way through to the semi-final, but he's found it just himself just unable to cope with Wallner. Game three.
Wallner.
This could be a critical moment, actually, for Wallner in the match. He's two games to nil up. And the only weakness I've ever seen in Wallner is times he can lose his concentration a little bit. But semi-final of the World Championships, I'm sure he's going to be completely focused.
2-1.
Good use of the push there from Wallner on the return. Used the wrist, dug underneath the ball. Rocket topspin off the bounce there from Jan. Just caught the edge of the table. But nevertheless, a very fast forehand topspin.
Oh. Immense power, topspin as well, just flicked over the top of Jan's back. The return seemed to be almost off the end of the table, but he was still good enough to pick his own edge.
Again, it's the side spin, hooking the ball, fading the ball, using side spin to take it to extremes on both sides of the table.
6-3.
Topspin on the service, Jan flicking off the end of the table.
Well, he only won the point in the end by a good deal of fortune.
Topspin there, just catching the top of the net. Desperate lunge from Wallner.
5-6.
Mesmerizing stuff, just a little flick. There's another former world champion, Jorgen Persson, watching on. Man who succeeded Wallner as the world champion.
5-8.
Again, heavy backspin on that push return. Jansen putting the ball in the net.
And the worry grows now for Jan against the serve. Jan is picking up points and he has 4-point advantage. So easy. Phenomenal. And just a little juggling with the foot to embellish it.
Amazing football skills here, let alone table tennis skills. What a backhand on the diagonal. And then as the ball goes up, he kicks it up in the air with his foot. I hope Glenn Hoddle's watching.
11-5.
Impossible to pick. There was a terrific take back, wasn't there? But you still didn't know if he was going to go down the line or across.
Exactly. You can see here that Jansen's not sure. Is he going to go out wide there, wide the other side?
13-6.
And of course, when you're not sure, when there's doubt in your mind, very difficult to react. And then Wallner very rarely misses.
Well played,
7,
yeah.
13, China.
All the trickery from Wellner. Countered there. So he starts his next sequence of serves 6 points adrift.
8-13.
Well played.
13.
He's still got his head up. He's still trying everything he knows. And wasn't that brilliant?
Full marks to Jan. He's still playing very positive table tennis, looking to get in with that forehand topspin.
That 10-13.
Stop it.
The reactions are phenomenal here. A rocket topspin from Jan, but the block there from Woldner. Incredible.
Hope 15-10. Sweden.
Well, a big mistake at an important juncture, and Woldner now has a 5-point cushion plus 5 serves to come. He could be very near victory after these.
16-10.
Backspin on the service, came underneath the ball. Very difficult for Jan to see the change in points of contact.
17-10.
Again, the backspin on the serve.
Ruthless.
18-11.
And he hates himself for missing that. What a perfectionist.
11-19.
First sign that Jan just might have resigned himself here. The first sign after what's been an extensive drilling by Woldner.
11-20.
I'm not sure there whether Woldner was inviting the top spin to have a bit of fun at the end of this game. But yeah, I'm missing it. Let's wait and see if Woldner wants a bit of fun.
9 match points.
12-20.
It's a big salute from Woldner's point of view. He doesn't give too much away, but he has performed in unbelievable fashion here tonight. And here's the moment we knew it would end in the grand manner, and it sure did. Just waiting for the big forehand, which finished it. The backhand setting it up. Here it comes, right to the very corner. Thank you very much, and he deserves the applause. Woldner, then, the world champion in 1989, is through to the final in 1997. He beats Jensen 3-0.
Semi-final, we're going to get underway on 4-2, 8:30.